In the previous video, we have seen how to use break and labeled break statements in do-while loops. So this is completed. In this video, we will see how to use continue and labeled continue statements in do-while loops. So we have seen what are continue and labeled continue statements in the previous videos. Let's see how to use these continue and labeled continue statements in do-while loops. So a continue statement is used to go to the end of a loop. For example, I have a do while loop here. So do, and I have the while condition here. So this is a do while loop and there will be a set of statements here. And now if I want to at a particular condition, if I want to come to the end of the loop, so I'll say if and I'll write some condition here. And I'll say continue. So when I say continue, if this condition is satisfied, then it comes to the end of the loop and then it goes back again and it will proceed with the remaining things. So this is how a simple continue statement is used. And a labeled continue statement. A labeled continue statement is used to reach to the end of the outer loop. That means, let's say we have two do while loops, one do while loop inside another do while loop. So let's say I have a do loop here and this is the condition here, while condition. And I have some set of statements here. I have another do while loop here, while condition, and I have another set of statements here, and based on some particular condition, if I want to come out of this outer loop, not come out, but if I want to come to the end of this outer loop, then I have to use a labeled break statement. So for that one, first I have to label this outer loop. So I have labeled this as outer and here I will say if condition and here I will say continue outer. So when I say this one, it will come to the end of this outer loop and then it will go back. So this is how a labeled continue statement is used. Let us see this one more time, a simple continue statement. If we want to come to the end of the current iteration or end of the current loop, then we will use a simple continue statement. So I have a do while loop here and in this do while loop, I have some set of statements. And if I want to come to the end of this current loop, then I will have some condition and I will put continue. And based on this continue statement, it will come to the end of the current loop and then it will go back again and it will proceed further. In a labeled continue statement, a labeled continue statement is used to come to the end of the outer loop. So here I have two do while loops here. This is one do while loop and this is another do while loop. So some statements go here in the outer loop and also in the inner loop. And if I want to come to the end of this outer loop, then I will have some condition and I will label this outer loop with some label. Here I have labeled it as outer and I will say continue outer. In this way, I can come to the end of the outer loop. So this is how continue and labeled continue statements are used. Let's see an example for each of these. I am creating a new class here and the class name is continue do while and I am using the main method here. Click on finish. And here I'm creating a do while loop. So first I'm initializing a variable here int I equals to 0 and I'll create a do while loop here. Do while I is less than 10 and put a semicolon. And here I'm printing the value of I, system.out.println I, and I'll increment the value of I here. So now let's run this one, run as Java application, and it is printing the values from 0 to 9. Now, when the value of I becomes 5, I don't want to print it. I'll simply go to the end of the loop. So, I'll say if I equals to 5, continue. If I do this one, what happens here is the I value is when it becomes 5, then it comes here and then it again goes here. But here it goes into a continuous loop because the value of I will never increment because it won't come to this point. So it will go into a continuous loop. So we have to increment the value of I here one more time. So I plus plus. So this is how we have to do. So let's run this one more time. Run as Java application. And now you can see that the value of 5 is not printed. It printed the values from 0 to 4 and then 6 to 9. So this is how we can use a simple continue statement in Java. Now let's work with labeled continue statement. So I am creating a new class here and the class name is labeled continue do while, and I am using the main method here. So here what I will do is I will create an outer loop first. So for that I will initialize a variable int I equals to 0 do while I is less than 10, and I will say system.out.println I and I plus plus. So this is similar to the previous program that we have written. And now I will create another do while loop inside this do while loop. So I will say another do while loop. So I will do int j equals to 0 do, condition is while j is less than 3, put a semicolon here and I will print it here, system.out.println. And for easily recognizing the values of j, I am putting two hyphens before the values of j and I will say j plus plus. So what I am doing here is I am printing the values of I and then I am printing the values of j. So for each value of I, it prints the values of j from 0 to 2. Let's run this one. So here there is, okay, so I have to put a semicolon at the end of this one. So let's save this one and let's run this. Run as Java application, and it is printing the values of I and j. For each value of I, it is printing the values of j as 0, 1, 2. Now, when the value of I becomes 5, I don't want to print the values of j. And also, I don't want to print the value of I as well. So, in that case, no, the value of I will be printed, but I don't want to print the values of j. So, if I equals to 5, I'll say continue. I should not write it here because I have to write it inside this one. So here I'll say if I equals to 5, then continue. So what happens here is it just comes out of this inner loop, but I want to come to the end of this outer loop. So I have to label this one outer and then I will say continue outer. So in this case, when the value of I becomes 5, it goes to the outer loop, end of the outer loop. So it won't print the values of j here. So let's run this one. Run as Java application, and you can see that the values of j are not printed after 4. When the value of I is 4, it becomes 5 here. So it is not printing the values of j after 4. So this is how we can use a labeled continue statement in a do while loop. In this video, we have seen how to use continue and labeled continue statements with do while loops. If you want to download the document, you can go to my repository at github.com/supposetech and go to selenium-java-tutorials. And this particular tutorial starts with numbering 20H. And here you can find it, 20H selenium-java-do-while-loops-continue and labeled continue. So you can download the document here. In the next video, we will see what is the difference between a while loop and a do while loop.